Hi, I'm Evelyn Salazar, a 3D designer from Peru, and today I want to show you how to create this type of balloon simulation. First, we will use the text tool and add the word we have chosen. Next, we'll select a font. It's important to choose one that really stands out. Opting for a bold font is an excellent choice, as it will make the effect we are adding look striking and highly noticeable. For this project, I selected Future Extra Bold. Since I plan to place this on my Instagram, I will adapt it to the dimension of 13050 and 1080. Positioning the letters this way is a great choice to make them look more powerful. The next step is to make the text editable. Use the connector tool and then make it editable again. This step is essential for achieving a polished finish in the animation. We need to add polygons to the letters, and using a mesh will help us modify them uniformly. Be sure to increase the density for the best results. Now, we will fix the edge to create the effect of extending the letters. Use the point and the back selection or loop tool. We will add balloons to simulate the inflation and movement effect. In the dresser tab, use the fixed point option. Now I'll test the parameters of a few options. Set bendiness to 50, which will help determine how flexible or rigid the object effect will be. For this project, target length works well at 140. Allowing us to the target length, allowing us to adjust and control the length of the letters. I'll set overpressure to 30 to manage the internal pressure, with a higher value causing the object to inflate more. We will also secure the back edges to ensure a consistent effect. Perfect. Finally, the parameters are set to bendiness 30, turbulence 100, and balloons 9. We will tell how it looks in the render view. Add a subdivision surface to smooth the letters. Now we will add light materials. I will use an HDRI and a couple of area lights. For the material, I will try the substance material. Finally, we will use the cache to reduce calculation times and avoid recalculating the simulation. This will help save the time during rendering. The next step is to add it to the render queue. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.